Why in the Old Testament, God, what you say?
Why am I angry? You are angry. Look, you are. Have you seen yourself on YouTube? Have you look? Have you seen yourself on YouTube? Angry on the ladder, being vociferous.
Are you a sinner?
No. What? Yeah. No. Don't help me. I'm a sinner. I tell you why. I'll tell you. Yeah. You are. Honestly, you know I will expose him. Yeah, that's why he's telling me. You're laughing. You know me. You know I'm going to expose him. He's lying, doesn't he? You know. He's not telling the truth. No. I use the Bible against. I got the Bible. No, I use the Bible. You know you're laughing because he's lying. He's lying, doesn't he? Yeah, I'm here. He cannot. No, bro. What truth?
You reject the truth.
Okay, what truth? Tell me. Okay, what truth? Tell me the truth. I said. Tell me the truth.
Jesus, yeah. The truth.
Okay, tell me.
The only truth.
How is Jesus?
Every week you come and
when you tell me, quote from the Bible. Jesus is the truth. Quote from the Bible. Can you quote from the Bible?
Go to John 14.
Oh, hold this one, give me a minute. Just 1 minute.
Go to John 14.
The Bible here. So, Sedek.
John 14:6,
yeah? Yes. And the way and the truth are the land. No one, what do you understand about that? So what do you understand about that?
What do you understand?
I'll tell you. Jesus, you know, John 14:6, yes. Jesus is the way and the truth are the land. No one comes to the Almighty God through him. Yes? Yeah? In his time. Through him, yeah?
That's not what he said.
Okay, listen. I'll tell you. But Jesus said, I was sent only to the what? No, don't run away. You be, no. Okay. Jesus, what he said? I was sent only to the lordship of the house Israel. Okay. Did he say that?
Okay.
Do you believe in that?
Yes, bro.
You believe in that? Yes. Jesus was sent to the children of Israel.
Right.
Yeah. That is why when he said, and the way, and the way and the children of life. No one comes to the Father but through me. Okay. That's what I said, to the children of Israel.
Yes.
Okay. Simple. But that John 14, 6, go to John 14, 1. What did he say? To debunk this myth of Jesus being God. John 41, read it.
He said, I've already read a Bible.
Now, I'm happy you're coming. You say, I'm bad. Now, I'm going to expose you. Read, you're smart, read it. I'll tell you that your trinity you believe in is a fabrication, it's a lie. Yeah, it doesn't exist. Don't run away. Don't get that. Please tell you Jesus is not God.
Let not your heart be troubled. You believe in God, believe also.
So what does that mean? When Jesus said, let not your heart be troubled. Believe in God and believe also in me. What does that mean?
That means believe in God and him.
And him.
Yes.
So believe in God and him.
Yes.
But he's not God.
He is God.
Can you hear yourself? Jesus, no. Let's put it. John 14:1.
This is what I'm not going to do.
Let me quote it.
Because I understand the word has been revealed to me from the Spirit, yeah? You can't read this verse and try and teach me your understanding. You understand it a certain way, I understand it a different way.
But the Bible said, no, the scripture, no personal interpretation.
Brother,
I said it.
Brother,
have you seen
this is simple.
Have you ever seen Jesus commanding the Father?
But John 14, yes.
Have you ever seen the case that Jesus telling the Father what to do?
No, there you go.
Because it's the word.
No, but what I'm saying,
have you ever seen the
what I'm saying, okay, John 14, 1, Jesus said to the disciples, Let not your heart be troubled. Believe in God, believe also in me. Distinction.
Do you believe that Christ?
No. Wait.
Do you believe that Christ commanded the Father to do something?
Okay. No.
Okay, but you know that's a contradiction because you don't believe that Christ commanded the Father to take the cup away from him.
What?
And that's what the Father did.
No. Who do you believe in? Hold on. Who believe in it?
I asked him, do you believe that Christ commanded the Father to
take the cup away from him? Let me give. No. He's running away. He's running away from me.
If you allow him to ask me a question, allow me to answer a question.
I didn't allow him.
You did, because you...
Let me.
Okay. If you give, okay.
This is my discussion, I'll let you.
Okay.
You're saying about the one Jesus, yeah, asking God, take this cup away from me. You're saying this commanding
God.
To what to do, right? That's what you're saying, right?
No.
Is that what you're claiming?
Right. But I said, first asked you the question. I said, do you believe that Christ commanded the Father to do such a thing?
No.
You said no.
Never. Not in the Bible.
I'm saying in your religion, in Islam, you believe that Christ commanded the Father to take the cup away from
him. He said we believe. Where the Quran?
He said we
believe that.
No,
okay. Wait.
That's
what I said. You said we believe in that. Where in the Quran?
Not as I will, but as you will. That's submission to the
Creator. It's not the Bible.
Okay. Right. Yeah.
In your Bible, not in the Quran, it said we believe that. You said we believe that.
Don't believe that Christ was crucified, right?
He said Christ commanded. No, he said Christ commanded God. Where in the Quran said Christ commanded God? That's what he said. Stick you in the camera. He said we believe that Christ commanded God
to take the cup away from
you. Okay, where in the Quran?
So therefore,
no, I said, where in the Quran?
Brother, I don't read the Quran.
But that's what he said.
I'm not going to be able to tell
you. He said, we believe in it.
I have spoken to Muslims, and there's some video footage in this Quran of someone saying this to me.
Someone said that you.
Yes, but I'm not going to mention any.
A Muslim
told me that the son told the father to take the cup away from him.
From the Quran, is it?
Brother,
that's not in the Quran.
Muslim told me this.
No. But that Muslim baby doesn't know.
Okay.
I said I'm here. So, I know.
You tell me something then. According to your Quran.
No. We're digressing here.
We're digressing. What's the account?
I think that you made a mistake. It's not the Quran. It's in the Bible.
Brother.
Then we can go on.
Brother.
It is not our belief. It's your belief. It's in the Bible.
According to your Quran, Christ was taken up and he wasn't crucified. Yes or no?
So you make sense
of that by saying that when Christ asked for the cup to be taken away from him, that's when the Father took the cup away.
Ask, not command.
What is that?
It's different between ask and command.
Okay. No.
Command.
That's how your Bible is not the Quran. Quran says, "Oma kataluhu, oma salabu." They kill him, not crucify him. But so it was made to appear. He never said, "Wait, this is in your Bible."
Brother.
Have you studied your Bibles? You are quoting from the Gospel of Gospel of Matthew, chapter number 26, verse number 39.
Okay.
That is no Bible, not in the Quran. Get that first. You can move on. It's the Bible.
Brother.
That's not our belief. If a Muslim said that to concur with you, he's referring to your Bible, not the Quran. We don't believe in that.
Brother, that's what I'm saying.
Yeah, but we believe that the Bible teaches that Jesus is God.
But Jesus is not God.
But Jesus clearly is God.
No. In the Bible.
All right, John chapter 12, verse 31.
Quote any verse in your Bible. Quote any verse, I'll put the context.
I am the first and the last.
Okay, so Revelation 22:13, Jesus says he is the first and the last. That's a divine title.
What?
Your faith believes that. So first
he said what?
By that.
No.
Revelation 22, verse 13, Jesus says in red letters, is the Alpha and the Omega, the first and the last. That's a divine title.
Hold
you would say should be held by.
By Allah.
Yeah.
He's the first and the last.
Yeah.
Yes.
Jesus is the first and the last.
Jesus in the first.
Do you know the first and last means?
That's a title that you're God.
Do you know the first? Listen to me. No, this is a revelation. Dream to John. This is a revelation.
Revelation is written by the same
author
who wrote the Gospel of John. In John's prologue, he starts by saying he is the Word, and that the Word became flesh.
No.
The Word was God.
You know, I know from John 1 to 1:14. I know the Bible inside out. It's not a single verse. Single verse, listen to me. Single verse you can quote from the Bible. I'll put the context. Not a single verse. I'll make a claim. I'll put this in the context.
Okay,
yeah.
Okay. How do you explain John 12, verse 31?
Let me.
John chapter 12, verse 41. Get your Bible. Let's read it.
Sorry?
John chapter 12, verse 41. Let's go. Let's read it right now.
Read it.
I'll read it. I will recite it to you.
Anywhere you call from the Bible, I've got another verse in the Bible to bury it. I'm here. Any verse, I'm going to use the Quran. I use another verse to bury it.
To
make this Bible a contradictory.
This is what I'm about to tell you. This is John chapter 12. Yes, I'm starting from verse 37. Even after Jesus had performed so many signs in their presence, they still would not believe in him. This was to fulfill the word of Isaiah, the prophet. Oh, he's quoting Isaiah. And he quotes, "Lord, who has believed our message, and to whom has the arm of the Lord been revealed?" And that's a quote from Isaiah. For this reason, they could not believe, John says. Because as Isaiah says elsewhere, he has blinded their eyes and hardened their hearts, so they can neither see with their eyes, nor understand with their hearts, nor turn, and I would heal them. And here we go, listen. Isaiah said this because he saw Jesus' glory and spoke about him. This is quote from Isaiah 6, where Isaiah has a vision of Yahweh. And John just said here in 41, Isaiah said this because he saw Jesus' glory and spoke about him. John just said that Isaiah saw Jesus as the divine Yahweh. He's just called Jesus Yahweh.
Who called
this is clear teaching in the Gospel of John that Jesus is divine. There is no question of this. This is why all scholars accept this. This is why atheists accept that Jesus claimed to be divine.
Let me talk.
This is one example.
Let me talk. I see what I'm telling you. We the Muslims are telling you, Jesus was a Messiah, the prophet, sent to the children of Israel. He never said he's God. He never said, worship me. Listen to me. Let me finish. Jesus, when he was on the earth, was praying to God.
He was.
No. Who was he praying to then?
He went to his father.
No, praying to God.
The Father. The Father is God.
Father is God. No, God is trying.
Yeah.
Okay, so I'm in the Bible.
It's like how Allah
listen to me. God is trying. Okay, this trying is God is talking about. It's not in the Bible. Let me finish. Okay, you can come to that. I told you.
Okay, you accept that Jesus is divine.
He called the verse, I put the context. Let me tell you something. Look, you know.
That's my question.
No. Look, before you go to that, you know what God said? God in the Old Testament? He said only one God. He's only one Lord. Mm. He has no partner.
There is one Yahweh.
Let me quote. If you read the Bible, it is Isaiah talking about. I don't think you Isaiah. Properly study Isaiah. I can quote Isaiah extensively. Where God is talking, there's only one. Let me quote. If you read, I quoted this extensively here. In the book of Isaiah, chapter 43, verse number 10 to 11.
I want you to answer what I just said.
I'm using the Bible. Jesus never called. Jesus called Yahweh. Is
he
a blasphemy?
He said he saw Jesus' glory.
Okay.
When he saw.
Who said that?
That's what John wrote. Yeah, saying that Isaiah had seen that.
Okay, John said that. What did Jesus himself say? You know. What did Jesus himself say? John 17:3. Who is the only true God? What does Jesus say in John 17:3? This John you're talking about, John 17:3.
Yeah, God, he said that he had the same glory that the Father.
No, John 17:3. First. Yeah. No, don't go to John 17:5. You're going to John 17:3.
Don't read the
You're going to John 17:5.
He wants to read just a part of it.
Listen. I'm here. I'm not going to John 17:3 first. Read John 17:3. I'm going to quote the Bible in the Old Testament. I'm going to quote at least a dozen verses where God is telling you there's only one Lord, no partner. And guess what? And there is nothing unto like Him. In the Quran, let me call you kufan ab. You don't even know God in your Bible. Listen to me.
About the Bible, yeah? I'm saying the Bible, the Gospel of John says Jesus is divine.
Listen. John said God is divine, yeah? John said Jesus is divine. Yeah. Listen to me. God in the Old Testament said he's only one Lord and there's nothing unto like him. And he's not a man. Now, what do you understand by? John said Jesus is God. John is God. Read the Bible. John is the last gospel. If you read the Bible, in the book, no, let me quote as well. You quote it. I'm going to debunk that.
You said 17:3.
In the book of Isaiah.
Let me read it. Let me read 17:3, and we can address that point, yeah? And then we can go on to your next point.
They're coming.
Brother.
Give him time. You can come.
Jesus Christ himself said that he's God in the book of John. Yeah. And he was worshipped in the book of John.
Yeah, he was worshipped.
So this is what I'm going to show you. Look, before we go to there, because
three of them.
We're not going to pay those.
Listen.
John 9.
Let me finish.
John 9.
Okay, wait. No, wait. We've got 3 minutes each. Look, 3 minutes each. 3 minutes, 3 minutes each. About 1 hour.
We are not Muslim to harm you. Don't be scared. We are not Muslim to harm you.
Asif is talking. Have respect. I will talk to you. Just have respect.
That they had cast him out.
Amen.
And when he had found him, he said unto him,
yes.
Dost thou believe on the Son of God?
Yeah.
He answered and said, Who is he, Lord, that I might believe on him? And Jesus said unto him,
What did he say?
Thou hast both seen him,
yeah.
And is he that talketh with thee?
Yeah.
And he said, Lord, I believe. And he worshipped him.
Yeah.
And he
worshipped him.
Right.
And Jesus said, For judgment I am come into this world, that they which see might not see, and they which see might be made blind.
Okay, you finish?
Are you finished?
We have it. Are you finished that? Let me talk. Are you finished? Let me finish.
Right.
If you read your Bible, in the Gospel of Matthew, chapter 4, verse number 10, Jesus himself said, worship the Lord your God and serve only him. Listen to me. Gospel of John, chapter 4, verse number 23. Jesus said, the true worshippers who worship the Father, for the Father seeks such to worship him. The true worshippers who worship the Father. The first worshippers who worship the creation. So we worship Jesus and anyone else, you are the first worshipper. Read that, John 4:23. No, go, read it.
Did Jesus come on his own authority?
No.
Did Jesus come on his own authority?
Sorry?
Did Jesus come on his own authority, or did he come in the authority of the Father? John 5 and 43, I have come in my Father's name.
You look.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah,
in my Father's name. He did not come on his own accord.
Yeah.
The Son and the Father are one.
No.
They are one in mine.
No.
They are not separate.
Is that Swami?
They are one in mine.
Hatu Burhanakum. Your Bible says so. Prove all things there. They are one in mine. Show me.
John 5.
No. Show me that one in mine. You people repeat nonsense. Huh? No, show me that one in mine. Show me. God the Son, show me. God the Son.
Jesus said,
God the Son. I have come in my Father's name, and you receive me not.
Yeah.
If another shall come in his own name, him you will receive. Christ literally came in his Father's name. His name is Yahushua. Amen. Yeshua, which means Yah is salvation.
Yeah.
Muhammad came in his Father's name.
Hold on. Why did Jesus now?
You have received him.
Okay, why did Jesus now?
Why did Jesus now?
Let me talk. Why did Jesus?
Yeah. Say that again.
Why is Jesus now?
In heaven.
In heaven. Under the Father.
No. No.
Where's Muhammad?
No.
Where's Muhammad?
In the grave.
Where's Muhammad?
Jesus. Who is supposed to be God?
Where's Muhammad?
Let me finish.
Where is Muhammad?
Let me address that.
Answer the question.
Okay. Let me address that. Jesus, who is supposed to be God?
Muhammad.
They said the Father is God, the Son is God, and the Holy Spirit is God.
Yeah.
These three are one in heaven. In heaven, why Jesus supposed to be God? But now in your Bible, in the Gospel of Luke, chapter number 22, verse number 69, they said, and we see that the Son of Man, Jesus, is seated at the right hand of the mighty God in heaven. Who is God there? Wait, who is God in heaven?
Where is Muhammad?
Where is Jesus? Where is Jesus? Where is Jesus?
Where is Jesus? According to Islam,
who is the mighty God? Who is the mighty God? Who is the mighty God? Who is the mighty God?
And he is coming back. Where is Muhammad? Where is Muhammad?
Okay, take it.
Where is Muhammad?
Let's take 3 minutes.
Where is Muhammad?
I got 3 minutes.
Where is Muhammad? Where is Muhammad?
See.
If Muhammad is a prophet,
look,
Jesus is prophet,
okay.
And Jesus is life.
Jesus
is living.
Look. We are debating.
And Jesus is coming back.
We are debating.
Where is Muhammad?
Where is Muhammad? If you're going to debate about the divinity of Christ, it has to be the whole Bible, not the John. John, you're talking about the Gospel of John.
Don't worry.
You can quote John, but what I'm saying, you can quote from John. What I'm saying, but I can quote from Matthew and Mark, because John is the last Gospel.
All right.
Matthew, Mark, Luke, and John.
Do you believe that
John came last?
Jesus was divine.
John came,
Do you believe that John taught that Jesus was divine? Yes?
Sorry?
Do you believe that John taught that Jesus was divine in his Gospel?
In the Gospel, in the John's Gospel, John's Gospel, John said Jesus is not divine.
He did say that.
No, he said it's not divine.
So he didn't say that.
No, John said Jesus is not divine. Jesus was not divine. Is that? I saw you.
Read John 9.
I'm going to Gospel of John.
We'll stick to the Gospel of John.
No. We stick to John. Okay, we stick to John. Is one.
Okay.
John. You're going to stick to John.
Okay.
You're going to stick to John. Okay.
Who is the Son of God?
Only John. Why only John?
Because it's easy. So easy.
Because in the Gospels, Matthew, Mark, Luke, and John. John is the last Gospel. When you hear about this divinity of Jesus Christ before him. Let's concentrate. When you talk about this divinity of God, God, you can only find in the John's Gospel. But when you go Matthew, Mark, Luke.
But you deny that John does. You deny that John does. I'm just going to prove John does.
No, I'm going to go prove that there. Verse in John, where Jesus himself proves that he's not God.
Okay, let's go from the Gospel of John. Yeah.
What Jesus said, the true God is the Father.
Go, John, that's it. If you uncle God, John, I'm all right.
He's sharing the same glory with him.
John.
from the beginning.
No.
Holy
no, true God. He wants
can
to
I answer him.
No. Leave
can I answer
no,
him?
No, let me debate. No, let me answer
him. No. Let me answer him.
No.
Then you can carry
on. I don't want to talk to him.
Let me answer him.
I don't want to talk to him.
Let me answer him.
I don't want to talk to him.
Then you can carry on.
He doesn't know how to debate.
Then you can.
No, he doesn't.
Then you can carry on.
He doesn't know how to debate. What I want to talk to him. He doesn't give you time.
So, I'm here to answer you.
Would he listen to me?
I'm here to answer you.
Would he listen to me?
I'm here to answer you.
He doesn't listen.
First of all,
I don't want to talk to
him. First of all, where is Muhammad?
You see,
where is Muhammad now? First of all, and even this satanic book.
Talk to you.
Even this satanic book says
Asif.
That there is a
Asif.
Guidance
Asif.
And there is a light
Asif.
In
Asif.
Torah,
Asif.
Zabur,
Asif.
And Anjil.
Asif. Asif.
Torah, Zabur, Asif. And Anjil.
I've been debating so, before you come. Listen, look,
so what are you
Asif.
Asking?
Asif. Asif.
What are you asking?
Oh, no. Do you want
why
to
are you? Why are you,
do you
going
want to debate
against
Asif.
Your book?
Do you want to debate with me?
Why are
I'm
you
asking
going
you.
Against your
I'm
book?
Asking. Do you want to debate with me?
Then there is a guidance.
No, okay. I'm asking.
There is a light.
Okay.
In that.
Okay. Do you want to debate
you
with me?
You have no right to ask.
Do you want to debate with me? Asif. I do want
you
to
have no right to ask question.
Do you want to debate with me?
If you want
no
to answer,
debate.
Stop.
Where is Muhammad now?
Okay, I'll answer it.
According to you,
I'll answer it.
According to you, Jesus is prophet.
These guys.
According
these
to
guys.
You, Muhammad is a prophet. According to you, Moses is a prophet.
Okay.
But Jesus is up in heaven. He's coming back. Where is Muhammad now?
Okay, listen to me. I see.
Where is Muhammad now?
I'll answer it.
Where is Muhammad now?
Answer
that question.
He's not going to answer the question.
Answer
that's why. No, they're more civil. They're not civil.
You're not going to answer
the question. No, what I'm saying.
But you haven't even answered
the question. I said, debate. Look, you are asking.
But
you are asking questions. Three of you, you're not giving me time. When you ask, you're not giving time. You're not. I said, you want to debate. I said, you want to debate.
You are beating around the bush.
But do you want to debate?
You are beating around the bush. You are not answering the question.
I want to debate.
Where is Muhammad now?
Listen to
answer
me.
Answer the question.
Listen to me.
Answer the question.
You want to debate?
Where is Muhammad?
I'll answer it.
Where is Muhammad? Where is Muhammad now?
Asala, answer it. You want to debate?
Answer,
answer
the question.
No.
Come on.
We debate.
On. Answer the question.
We debate.
Answer the question.
Do you want to debate? This is for
where?
Look, here.
Where is Muhammad?
Okay, let me debate with man.
Where is Muhammad?
No. He doesn't want. But I'm debating with him. I will debate with man here.
Where is Muhammad?
We've been debating before you came, you see.
According to you, Jesus is prophet.
You see, this guy.
According to you, Muhammad is prophet.
This man.
Where is Muhammad?
This man.
Jesus is up in heaven.
This man has got psychological problem.
Jesus is up in
at home.
Where is
the wife beats him up.
Where
he comes
Muhammad
here.
Don't say that.
No, I'll say that.
Why?
No, I'll say that. The problem with you. He's got me. Why? What should I say? I tell you why. No, I tell you why. No. Listen to me. This man comes here. Listen to me. You said no. This man comes here. Listen to me. And insults our prophet. Do you know how we? No. Listen. Listen to me.
I'm asking.
No. He says.
Did I insult him?
Have you listened to the video about
pedophilia?
No. You gotta be careful. No. I don't respect this man. He said something about prophet. Do you know what he said?
He talked about Muhammad having sex with a 9-year-old. Yes.
Sorry.
Did he talk about that? Did he talk about Muhammad having sex with Aisha, which was 9? Is that true? Is that true?
You see, I'm biting. You see what I'm saying? I'm debating with the wonders of God.
Okay.
He's coming and biting in. I'm telling you.
Right.
So when I say something, you shouldn't say it.
Okay.
I don't want to talk about it. I said, he's not listening to you.
He's not listening to you. Did he mention about Jesus?
You see, I'm saying these guys are wasting my time. I want a proper debate. I can debate with all of them, one by one, so you can see that they have studied their Bible. They escaped.
No.
I study my Quran. I'm here to proper debate.
Sure.
3 minutes each. They escaped. I want a debate. 3 minutes each. No, we have no. Wait, half a minute later. No question.
I have a question.
You see, they only ask questions. No, listen to me. No. Can you debate? No. We have a proper. Listen to me. Let's have a proper. Listen to me. Let's have a proper debate. A moderator.
Answer.
3 minutes. A moderator. Anybody, I'm here. You see, look at them. I want a debate. I'm going to talk.
Okay.
I can debate all of you.
You have nothing to debate. You have no even answer.
I have a simple question.
Oh, give me that. You know, Satan again.
That's the best.
This guy
answer about
has got a mental problem. He's got a psychological problem. Why is your daughter? It's because your daughter is a Muslim.
Where is Muhammad?
Because your daughter is a Muslim. Because this man's daughter took his shahada to become a Muslim. He's told her that. I didn't even call you.
What do you say?
Where is Muhammad? Where is Muhammad now?
This guy is dumb, man.
Answer
you come
question.
Here shouting like a madman.
Where is Muhammad now?
Look at this.
Answer that question.
Can we debate?
Answer that
question. You can't debate. cannot debate. You can't debate.
According to you, Jesus is prophet.
He cannot even read.
According to you, Muhammad is a prophet.
He cannot even read.
Jesus is up in heaven.
Can you debate?
He's coming back.
Can you debate?
But where is Muhammad?
Okay, can you debate?
Where is Muhammad?
Can you debate?
Yeah.
Can you debate?
Go ahead.
No, okay.
Answer the question.
Can you debate? Can you debate?
I will debate with you.
Yeah, answer
once
it.
Once you answer that.
No, debate is not. I'll answer it.
Answer my question.
No.
Where is Muhammad?
Look.
Where is Muhammad?
Look, I'll answer it. I don't want to escape when you have a debate.
Where is Muhammad?
I'll answer it first. 3 minute debate. I'll answer that first. I will debate. I don't expose you.
You have nothing to
do. You're not a believer of Jesus. Yeah, you haven't studied your Bible. You talk nonsense, yeah. Bollocks. Bank up. You come here, shout like a donkey.
This is
you can't debate. Can you debate? Can you debate? Week in, week out, this madman comes to speaker's corner. No, biting, heckling. You can't debate. Look at you. Look at you.
Where is Muhammad?
You know, when they are home, they go from their wives. Look at maybe wife beat you up. Look at you. Comes here. No, you sound like a donkey. You can't debate.
Where is Muhammad?
Every week comes in here, all he does.
No. Where is Muhammad?
Maligning Rasul Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, say bad on a Muslim. You can't debate.
Where is Muhammad?
Let's debate.
Where is Muhammad?
Can't debate.
Where is Muhammad?
See, I came here. I'm a gentleman.
This
man, debate with a man. And he comes in, a shayateen comes in here. Disturbing the debate. We are having a debate, a civilized debate, a civil debate, this man will come in and heckle. And disturb everything.
Answer that question.
He's not listening, sir.
Answer that question.
I said I don't want to speak to him, but he can't
answer that question.
Tell him that. He's not listening.
He's not going to answer.
Yeah. So let him. Yeah.
He's not answering.
Yeah. I'm not answering. Yeah. So are you handsome? I'm scared of. Yeah.
Shame.
Okay. Let me debate. Yeah. Let me debate. Thank you. Go now.
So look.
No, we don't need you. Go. Yeah. Let's debate.
Don't be rude.
Okay. Let's debate. Yeah. Let's
say okay,
yeah,
three minutes.
Okay. Yeah.
I'll go first. All right. Cool.
You can go first.
So the Gospel of John clearly.
No, sorry. So God. No, I mean, no.
Okay. The Gospel of God, John, clearly teaches the divinity of Christ, and it does so in many ways. The clearest one is the fact that in John's prologue, the very beginning of the Gospel of John. The very beginning of the Gospel of John, in John's prologue, it talks specifically about Jesus being the Word that was incarnate. What was the Word? It says in John 1, and the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. This is clear cut. That's John 1:1. In John 1:14, the Word becomes flesh and dwells among us. This is clear case that Jesus is with God in the beginning and then becomes incarnate.
Right.
That is clear cut, end off. But even if you don't accept that, we have plenty of other reasons in John to accept that John taught that Jesus was divine because John knew that Jesus was divine. Case point, John chapter, give me a second, 17 verse 5 clearly states, I know very much after your beloved 17:3, where he says there is one God, that is eternal life, they may know you, the one true God, and Jesus Christ whom you have sent. But then it goes on to say that Jesus shared glory with that one God from the very beginning, which is a continuation of the very intro to John's Gospel. In John 1, the Word was with God, and the Word was God. He is consistent throughout his Gospel. In John chapter 14, verse 6, it's clearly said that if you see the Son, you have seen the Father. He is equating himself with Yahweh. Jesus does this repeatedly. He does it through the fact that he says that he has the authority to judge. That is a divine title. Jesus says that he can listen and hear to your prayers and he can answer them. That is in John 14, verse 13 to 40. He can answer prayers. This is clearly the case that Jesus is teaching that he is divine. We fully affirm that Christ is both fully man and fully God.
Amen.
And they are not inseparable. This is clearly taught in Scripture and is clearly taught in the Gospel of John.
So our brother here, this man here, goes to the John, the last Gospel. We know the only Gospel. Matthew, Mark, Luke, John, you'll have this Jesus being God, that Christians call all the time is in the John. Nowhere in the Old Testament, nowhere in the other Matthew, Mark, and Luke. Now he quoted John. He quoted John 1:1. In the beginning was the Word. In the beginning was the Word. And the Word. Yeah, I'm here. I'm here to the anyone. I'm here. Yeah, I'm here. You just said, no, they're biting. John 1:1. In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. And John 14, and the Word became flesh and dwelt among us. John says that, not the Word of Jesus. I'll come in and finish. And then he quotes it. No. This word, let's say, in the beginning was the Word.
But do you believe
it? And the Word, look, in the beginning. No, look. Muslim didn't watch. They're there. In the beginning. In the beginning was the Word. In the beginning, now I'm asking the Christians. In the beginning was the Word. And the Word was with God. And the Word was God. I'm asking, that Word in the beginning, was that Word God? That Word in the beginning, was it God?
Yes.
Because.
If you want me to answer.
Yeah. But the Bible, in your Bible, God said there's no God with him. That's why I said you haven't read your Bible.
There's no God outside.
No. God said there's no God with him in the beginning. No.
Besides it.
No God besides it. He doesn't believe what he's awarded.
The Word was an attribute of God. The Word was an attribute of God that was coexistent with God as an attribute.
If you in the book of Deuteronomy, this is the book of Deuteronomy. Yeah, God said here in the book of Deuteronomy. Yeah, in the book of Deuteronomy, God said that, and he said there is no God with him. You understand? So let's go to the John 1:1. He said, in the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. Now, verse number 2 puts it in the context. It says, and he, that is the Logos, that is Jesus, was with God. Now, who was with God? Verse number 2, John 1:1 says, well, John 1:2 put the context. And he, that is Jesus, that is the Logos, was with God. Now, who was with God in the beginning? Who was with God? I'm asking you.
The second person.
No. Where it says second person of Trinity in the Bible? It's not there. You see, you are programmed in church.
This is God.
No, show me. No, look.
This is God.
The Quran said, how to prove. Your Bible said, look.
Who became
God? Your Bible said, prove all things. So when he says something, I want you to quote it. I don't want your opinion. The second person of Trinity. He said the second person of the Trinity. Was it God? Why in the Bible? It's not there.
Let's have a look.
God the Son is not in your Bible.
That's God worship. Did Jesus
God the Son is not in the Bible. You can show me.
Why God?
Fully man, fully God is not in the Bible. But you're telling church, Jesus is fully man, fully God on the earth. He's not there. So you're saying things, you're repeating.
Listen, we know that in the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. You've already said it.
So who was with God? No, verse number 2. Okay, verse number 2.
Let's read verse number 2. He was with God in the beginning.
Who was with God? Who?
The Word.
The Word was with God in the beginning. Who was?
Second person.
No. What? Show me. He didn't say. Remember, he not said the second person of the Trinity was with God. He said the Word, which is the Logos. So who was with? No, don't go. You want to know? You started John 1:1. Who was with God in the beginning?
You have not answered my question.
No. I'm asking it. No.
I said clearly to you that Jesus was there. The Word in the beginning was the Word, and the Word became flesh, and that is Jesus Christ.
But you're quoting out of context. You quoted John 1:1.
It's divine.
So John 1:2. Don't do that.
With God in the beginning.
John 1:2.
And then he became incarnate.
Who was with God in the beginning before he became incarnate?
The Son of Man. The one that was talked about in
the Son of Daniel. The Son of Man with God.
The Father, yes.
No, he didn't say it with the Father. Who was with God in the beginning? The Word was with God. The Logos.
With God, yes. The Logos.
Who is that word?
Jesus Christ.
So Jesus was with God.
The man who was with God.
No. He didn't say that. You see, I called him. But he didn't say that. The Bible says, the Bible says, proof all things. I want you to show me.
Absolutely.
No.